So moving on to the next topic of this chapter, functions. In functions, you should be very thorough with the relations before coming to this topic. So in case you are not thorough with that, please go through that video once again and go through the notes and what are the examples given and then come to this topic. Yeah. So here, yeah, the definition of function, it says that it is a special type of a relation. So it is a relation. A function has to be a relation. Okay? It is a relation where every element of one set has one and only one image corresponding to the other set. Okay? There are two sets available. Like whenever it is a relation, obviously two things are needed. Correct, no? So two sets are needed. So two things are needed over here. So one thing is related to other. That is a random relation. Like one, some relation is there between the two sets. That is called as a relation. Now, every element has one and only one relation with the second element. Second set. Every element of set 1 has one and only one relation with the sets 2. That is called as a function. So, words which I have underlined, this is one thing, every element and one and only one. Okay? One image. So, that range, image you know, what is the domain and range you know. Correct, no? We have studied about that in the previous topic. Image, pre-image, domain, everything. Correct, no? Image also have done. Correct, no? So recall that. So this thing, it should have only one and only one image, and every element should be interlinked to the second one. So that is how the function is formed. So to understand that, we'll take an example. This example number one. So here, every element is having this particular image. Yes, every element is having one and only one image. Correct. So this type of this thing is called is what is one thing in that problem? One image, that is one relation. This is this set. There is extra one thing remaining out. Correct or not? So that is why this cannot be called as a function, but this is a relation. It is a relation, but it cannot be called as a function. So in case this would be more specific if I tell like this. Okay? Like this. Starts from 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that. This thing is left out, which is not having this thing is not having a image on the other side. That means this thing is left out. Every image. No. 6 is not having any relation with 7. Correct or not? So that is why this can be called as a relation but not a function. Understood? This is a relation but not a function. Next to the second example which we have studied while going through the relation topic. So there is Gobi Manchurian, Chicken Biryani and Paneer Pizza. Remember this three dishes, correct? So we were having all these new people also in with us. So Liam has opted for Chicken Biryani. Matt also wants Chicken Biryani. Correct? So we know that the Chicken Biryani is having two images. Which is second condition is ruled out. It should have only one image. That means Chicken Biryani only one plate is there. Liam also wants Mac also wants. We cannot share, no sharing allowed. Understood? So we cannot make a function out of it. Yeah? So simple way here also Gobi Manchurian also. Sakshi also wants and Aditi also wants and there is somebody else. No. That's all. Correct? No? So two people want that one particular dish. There is only one plate available. I cannot give it to others. No function formation. So, Paneer Pizza also, Dhruv and Aditya wants. Correct, no? And Rachel doesn't want anything. What do you want, Rachel? You don't want anything. That's all. So, clearly we can see that things are not interlinked also. And also, we are having more than one image. It is possible that Dhruv also wants chicken biryani. Correct, no? More than one image also is possible. And this can be converted to a function only when, suppose Mac opts out, okay, I don't want chicken biryani. Correct? I don't want chicken biryani. Then Liam will take chicken biryani. Mac might take pizza. And who? Sakshi, okay, Aditya also is not there in today's class, so we will not give him anything. Mac and this one. So Paneer Pizza also, Dhruv is not there in today's class, we will not give anything. This is possible only when Mac is taking Paneer Pizza, Aditya also should not give anything. So only when we are giving food to Ayan, Matt and Sakshi, which means three. Right? So only three people. Others we are not giving any food. So this converts itself into a function. You can see the every element of one set, that is this set, the dishes set, okay, the dishes set is linked to other element. This has nothing to do with it. This has nothing to do. Images need not be. Images can be many. They can be many people. It is my wish whom to give or not. Correct? No? That's how a function can be created using this. So image has nothing to do with the first set, whatever it is. But all the elements in the first set has to be having an image of the second set. And only one image, not more. Clear? Fine. So like that, check this one example. A little confusion will be there while going through the topic. So this can be converted, you know how to convert a relation and to a non-relation function to a relation or relation to function, remember. Then this one over here, whether this is a function or a function or not. Check it. Check the definition. Every element of one set should have one and only one image corresponding to the other set. Okay, two is having image of one. Correct. One image of the set. Three is also having one image. Correct. Only one image is there. It's not like three is going and falling on two. Correct. It is falling into same image, okay, but it is having only one image. No? Two and three have same image. That's all I can tell. So I can tell here one and only one image. Yes, it is satisfying both the conditions. So this thing is a function. Here? So this is function. This is just a relation, not a function. This is a function which I created it right now. Previously it was just a relation. We can convert it into a function in whatever example I gave you. So this I hope clears your doubt about function and relation difference. Clear? So go through this video if at all it is not very clear, that will be understandable for you. We'll see. If at all not still not confusing is there, I will make another video out of it and get it. Clear? So then over here we need to know about two simple topics. This can be asked for the exams in the operative. Single one mark numericals may be like that, or also it can be asked in the competitive exams. What are these things there? Some example they can give and tell whether it is a so-and-so function or not. So that type function is called as one function such as is called as real valued function. Okay? Real valued function name itself is indicated. Name itself is known. That is a function whose range is either a set of real numbers. That is one definition. Whose range should be a set of real numbers. Or its subset as its range. Whose subset itself is a range of that particular set. Such a function is called as a real value function. Real numbers, a set of real numbers. That is how I can tell it is a real valued function. Next comes a function that is about the just a real function, not a real value. A function whose domain, here it was range, here it is domain. Range is numbers. Domain, like previous from where we are picking this type of, whose domain is also a real number or the subset of R. It is called as a real function. Whether it is a real number or a subset of real number, then it is called as a real function. Whose domain? If the range is also that, then it is going to be a real value function. Here, we'll check an example. This is a very simple example which we have done. They are given that the function is going from the natural numbers. Set of function is nothing but a natural number. So natural numbers we already know it starts from 1, 2, 3, 4, like that, correct? Or the set of natural numbers. It goes on till whatever number it is. Okay. So obviously I know that if it is 1, that is x values are this one and f of x values are here. According to definition, I can go on finding its different values. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that, it continues. When it is 1, what is the value of f(x)? 3. 2? 2, 4, 5. Correct. Then? 7. 9. Then? 11. Real numbers. Whose range is also real. This is an example for real valued function. Here? Understood, no? Whose domain is also real number? This is also a real number. It is a real function as well as a real value function. Yeah? So they might ask you in the exam, check whether it is a real function. Check whether it is a real value function. So and so function. So you come to know, yes, like this. Suppose there was something like my that was there. That would not form a real function. Real value function or real function. Understood? So that is how you can differentiate between the real value and non-real. So maybe we'll come across few examples later when coming to it. We'll go through it and find out. And next comes about the graphs. That graph I teach you after you go through few of the examples and exercise questions in your textbook. Okay? Go through the exercise questions and finish up the exercise. How much ever is covered up in this topic. That is about the functions. It's a very small exercise, last exercise. In fact, probably real valued few problems are there or not, we don't know. We'll see what it is. Just that graph part, I'll do it on the, after the exercise is done. Yeah? So we'll go through these topics and go through the finish of the exercise.